Mea fahum dingir okura. Mea fahum dingir okura.
Oh shit. Okay. Let's see.
Fahum dingir okura.
Where else do I post? Right here. Okay, do I have a couple more places to send it?
BGG.
Hello. How are you?
Hello. I'm okay. Sleepless but okay.
Aww. What do you mean sleepless? You said you, like, slept all night. I mean all day. Still tired?
And then I died and sleep to that.
Mea fahum dingir okura.
I'm sorry, Lexi. Or should I say Vessi? I'm sorry. I wonder if I should run corrupt. Probably. It's funny because whispers can't be used very well on Plague, from what I gather. Iron Maiden. Nope. Any survivors that are within your terror radius while another survivor is put into the dying state will yell and reveal their location.
Thought Plague.
I'm just gonna run with Corrupt Intervention for now. I want to use the prayer tablet, but that means I can't really puke on survivors.
Mea fahum dingir okura.
Well, there's no time like the present. Let's do it. Are you sad to see the demo go?
Kinda, but I couldn't loop demos for shit.
I'm one of the few people who has Demogorgon now. Or I should say, I will be one of the few people who has Demogorgon. Be her side boob in this. Is that cursed? You can see her side boob. Really? Someone brought a petrified oak? Okay. We're gonna have to sweat on our first game as Plague. Oh, sweetness. We got another person watching. You came in at just the right time. Good sir. You came in at just the right time. We're loading into a match. And I hope you are well. Come on, load. I think I need two more levels before I'm able to buy something from the Shrine of Secrets. Aww. And they went away. Oh wow, she is very tall. Okay. Okay, so you just charge it up. Red means my pool of corruption is ready, right? I think so. When it's highlighted in white like that. Nice. Now we got somebody sick. Okay, now that's two pools, and you just cleansed. Oh, wow. That was a lag spike. Yeah, Okay, fine. Fuck you. I didn't expect this first game to go very well at all, anyway. I probably should go for my pool. Damn it. Fucking Fang go.
Want to become famous? Buy followers and viewers on bigfollows.com.
Ban him. Ban him.
Fuck yo bitch ass. Bean.
Yay, I can actually puke on the exit gates. Too bad I won't be getting any. I'm just gonna have to learn Plague the hard way. Maybe I should re-up my corruption. That was a bad idea. They got greedy. They could have all escaped. Because I suck. They could have all escaped. But they got greedy, and now I have one kill on my first match. I'd say that's a small one.
Lurking.
Practice my arc. Just let me practice it. Really? You wouldn't let me infect you? That's okay. B- Thank you for banning that that bot, by the way. I appreciate that.
OFC.
Oh. I have a challenge I can bring. I only got 14,000, but that challenge should help me out. OFC means of fucking course, right? Like, of fucking course I did, or some shit like that. Is that what it means?
Of course.
Oh. Hit two different survivors with your weapon within 60 seconds. Do this 4 times. That'll probably be a little bit harder as Plague, but that's okay. Out isn't an option. Prevent the exit gates from being opened while using no way out 1 time. Okay. Nice. Yeah. I don't think I have no way out yet. Oppression! Yay! Playing the twins paid off. Even though it's only level 1, oppression is just good. Good to have. Damn it. I need 4,000 for plaything. I wonder if I should just run with oppression anyway. Yeah, I'm just gonna run with oppression anyway. Oblinium incense. Survivors who cleanse get their auras revealed for 4 seconds. And decrease cooldown of Vile Purge and Corrupt Purge by 0.25 seconds. Sure. Hunting category, sure. What the heck? He even whispered to me. What the fuck? I'm gonna block this bitch. I can't believe the bot whispered me. Vommy mommy. Vama mama. I actually got this this incense from the Halloween tome. I actually don't think I like her first incense, the profane censer. Ant paste censer. Ant paste. I'll just go with Frosty Eyes. I wonder what they're gonna do for their winter event. Also, side boob. Side boob. Searching for a match. Jada.
Mea Fahung Dingir Okura.
Here's the baby. I love you, Jada. Mwah. Again, fucking side boob. Great, we got a witch bitch. Spotted owl wreath hunting category 50%. Is my challenge within 40 or 60? 60 seconds. It should force the survivors closer to me with corrupt intervention. Hi, Jada. How much you want to bet it's Shroud of Union? Or Binding? Ofka. Jada. Jada. Da 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 da. Boom. I love you, baby. Did you know I love you too, Vessi? No. Fucking seriously. I didn't know you could grab them while they were cleansing. That's a nice little detail. Cleansed right over there. Are they above me? They're above me. God damn it. Thank you. Fuck! God damn it. Thank you. There's a pool below. Hmm. I gotta get rid of this fucking boon totem. Wherever the fuck it is. It's this same fucking boon totem again. Really, bitch? Hi, bitch. Bitch. Oh, wow. Basement is down here. Oh, And I did not expect to get a 4K this match. That was very unexpected. They're gonna make this as long as possible. Even though I got a 4K? Come on. Oh, I got 26,000. Mostly because they were mostly gold medals, it looks like. I wonder if Lexi is asleep. If they're asleep, that is okay.
A.
I thought you had fallen asleep. Which I would have been totally fine with, of course. Shell. Increases object infection duration by 20 seconds. I'll take that. Nah, let's go with the Spotted Owl Reef for now. Jada. What you doing over there, baby?
Mea Fahun Dingir Okura.
Jada girl. Come here. Come here, honey. Are you okay over there? Do you like it over there? Miss Jade Oeda? No, we're going with that hollow shell.
Mea Fahun Dingir Okura.
there's like one Fang in the lobby. Kind of hilarious. Nah, it's just me. Aww. It's just me. Object infection duration and seeing their aura.
S C H L E R P
Slurp Cutie
S C H L E R P Slurp.
Okay. What? Someone got infected.
Infect these nuts.
Oh my god, I fucking hate this level. Fuck you. They went back to that fucking generator. Fuck's sake, man. How can I not get this bitch? Fuck you, you fucking cunt whore. Not gonna be a good match.
Moving into bed.
Okay, hon.
Be watching on Xbox soon.
Alright. Fucking kill. Oh, I'm so good.
Don't beat yourself up.
I know, it's just... They were, like... That one dude was running me, so...
You're using a level 5 plague at rank reset.
I just didn't even get my challenge, man. Feels bad, man. Let's see. 3, 3. Yep, I'll have enough. Because it'll be 11,000. For now, I'm going to get rid of oppression.
I gonna...
What? Go with infectious fright. The cries of the unfaithful make your heart leap.
Tooch your booty.
Any survivors that are within your terror radius while another survivor is put into the dying state will yell and reveal themselves for 5 seconds. Hunting category, corrupt intervention.
Mea Fahum Dingir Okura.
Alright, let's start looking for the next match. You gonna touch my booty? Is that what you said? I just can't believe I got...
To wash your booty.
I just can't believe I got a 4K on my second match. Like, damn. Like, how did that happen on RPD? I wonder what this one is. Healing salve. Oh, decreases cooldown of vile and corrupt purge by a quarter of a second. Emetic potion. Is it emetic or ematic? Increases the effectiveness of vile purge by 30%.
Mea Fahum Dingir Okura.
Match. I could also use Dark Devotion, but I don't really want to focus on my fucking obsession. Okay. wonder if Calm Spirit was there to counter Infectious Fright. I could have seen death. Maybe.
It does counter it.
Okay. All personal BP offerings. Well, I guess we'll know if anybody has Calm Spirit. If they, end up not proccing Infectious Fright. I mean, if they're near me, of course. Hematic. I think it's hematic. Yeah, hematic seal. Okay. Oh, okay. So they're gonna be forced onto these two. Ezio!
No.
Oh, I landed in Ezio! And it looks like someone's up there. Damn. I love landing Ezios. Oh, you're going down. What the? Oh, fuck you. What the hell? Okay. So they're on two generators. Again. Damn, bro. Did you really try and blind me?
Rhea!
What do you mean, no? I'm taking you to the basement, too. Ooh, that was close. One has calm spirit. Somebody cleansed. I got the ball. And someone... I bet you I walked right past a survivor, too.
In my opinion, don't pick up Corrupt until you know where a survivor is.
Ah! How did you avoid that? Man, I got it right as it ran out. Yet another 1K.
TF you mean? You're on track for a 2K.
I forgot that I got the bill so early in the match. It made the rest of the match harder for them. Dare I say, Plague's playstyle is spray and pray.
Bonk. Bionk. Bionk.
Oh. That's right, I did my challenge. Okay, what's this one? Earn 75,000 blood points. I will eventually. Yay, level 10! Deathbound. Let's run for that. Fucking spray and pray. I'm proud of myself for that one. Now, oppression is worth running. It's really hard to run it at level 1. Because the value of it is just so infrequent. Why does it fucking do this to me? It shuts off my monitor when I'm streaming. But it doesn't do that when I'm fucking watching YouTube videos. Like, what is the fucking difference? I don't think I'm gonna get much value out of that brutality category. Okay. an extra coin and extra, I mean, extra chest and extra BP. Someone must be running, like, a chest perk. Oh man, I should have told you to clip that. The fucking spray and pray. I should have told you to clip that. That would have been hilarious. I should have thought to clip it myself. That's okay. It will be captured in the VOD. Oh my god. The family residence. They're gonna wait out corrupt, aren't they? Did I scare you? Good golly. Took me a while to grab you. Come on, I thought I customized the hook. What? Two generators already? Did I infect them again? Gotcha. Good dead hard. I don't know why I did that. I'm going to give them a choice.
Passing hour. Out.
Okay, honey. You go to bed. She had hope. Or adrenaline. You go to bed. I haven't seen a bill this entire fucking game.
Yeah.
Okay, bitch.
Fahun Dingir Okura.
I'll go with Deathbound.
Mea Fahum Dingir Okura.
Deviousness category. I feel like Plague is devious.
Yeah, sure. There are some stories like David and Jonathan, where Jonathan shows his friendship by giving him striptease, which, to be clear, the story would be a whole lot more wholesome if they just came out and said that they were lovers. But in 2 Thessalonians 3, it tells you to basically shun anyone who doesn't obey what is laid out in that letter. 2 John 1 tells you to not allow anyone into your house or to even greet anyone who doesn't bring the teaching.
Mea Fahum Dingir
Okura. It's not a great form of friendship. And I could go on with the rest of the things that you listed. For every verse or story that you can find that shows some positive quality for any of the things that you've said, I could find a verse or story that is atrocious on that very same matter.
The Bible also teaches children more effectively than any they are not the center of the universe.
I mean, that's debatable, but sure. A book that advocates child abuse and even has the death penalty for a child who is sufficiently disobedient could certainly be used to teach a child that they are unimportant. But again, on the flip side, you often hear children's versions of these Bible stories emphasizing that God loves them so much that he did X, Y, or Z for them. So the all-powerful creator of the universe cares deeply about you personally. But at the same time, you really suck and aren't worth such attention, so you better appreciate it and feel bad anytime you do or think anything that isn't
right. They're accountable to their parents and to God.
I have a question. Beginning of the video, you said,
and you don't have to be religious to read it, and your children don't have to be religious to enjoy it.
So, as a non-religious parent of non-religious children, why would you think that I would want my kids to feel like they're accountable to God? Especially when God's moral system is so very, well, immoral.
Children who internalize this lesson are much more likely to be kinder and more mindful of how they behave than those who do not.
Citation needed. Now, PragerU, if you're willing to dig a bit, they do list sources for what they say, and usually the sources end up being things like articles written on the PragerU blog or other PragerU videos, but occasionally you actually find something legitimate. But for this claim, that internalize the message that they are accountable to God will be kinder and more mindful of how they behave, or not, no reference whatsoever. Not even a mention of such a claim on the list of references. Now, I did look into it. There is a certain correlation between kids raised with religion and behavior, but the effect of religion is questionable, as the relationship goes away when you control for things like parent-child relationships. In other words, having a good relationship with your kids is likely much more important when it comes to getting your kids to behave properly than religion is. And, of course, there was that whole thing where weekly church attendance showed a correlation with better behavior.
Bible discourages narcissism.
I mean, narcissism is a personality disorder, and not only am I not qualified to diagnose it, but even for qualified people, it's always a bad idea to attempt to diagnose people that you have never met in person. But if we're just talking about people having a sense of their own self-importance, and thereby using a medical term in a way that...
What?
The creator of the universe thought you were important enough that he would specifically around you fits the bill. I mean, hell, here you are suggesting that even non-religious people should read your holy book, because your holy book is obviously the most important place to get these lessons from, even though there are other holy books with the same lessons, not to mention actual entertaining books that teach these lessons. And while you're sitting here feeling all self-important about your book, you point out that the book teaches you not to be self-important. And you somehow... starts to say that it's not even a children's book.
It's a library of wisdom for everyone.
Only if you have a really weird definition of wisdom.
Here's how Abraham lived, who was not a churchman, but who was steeped in the Bible, described. In regard to this great book, it is the best gift God has given to him. But for it, we could not know right from wrong. And all things most desirable for man's welfare are to be found portrayed in it.
Okay, what's your point? I disagree with Abe Lincoln on that point. Do you think that because he is generally regarded as having been a pretty good president of the United States, that now everybody has to take what he says as being true?
As Lincoln suggests, the Bible is the moral foundation on which Western civilization is built and a point of shared reference.
Yeah. Whether the idea that Western civilization, particularly
okay,
the book The Founding of Them by
Dead Dog.
And actually, as long as we're on the topic, this kind of betrays just how American-centric this guy's thinking is. Western civilization is a term that typically refers to ancient Greece as having been the foundational culture. And ancient Greece, not sure if you knew this, but it was decidedly not Christian. So when he says Western civilization, what he means is American civilization. And even on that point, he's wrong.
Up until the 1960s, you could cite a Bible story, and most people knew exactly what you were talking about. Everyone.
Huh. Let's do it. We got Dead Dog. Okay. There's one down below. Oh, hi there.
Here.
Like, seriously?
When you re ready to press star, we LL support you with everything dogeb.com.
Oh my fucking god. Huh. What else should I use? You know what? I think that's good for the night, for the stream at least.